Welcome back. So, we are on our fourth video.
Honestly, she doesn't even know what video she's on. Poor Tink Tank.
Here's where we are. Started and added some more detail to the sky. Let's jump right on into it. We're coming down to the water. I mixed a little Indian yellow with a little bit of liquid white. And as you can see, I'm not too particular about where I put the paint. I'm going to wipe it back anyway. And I really don't care if it hits the land, because I actually want that effect. But I don't want it that much, apparently. Again, I took a little bit of phthalo blue and a little bit of liquid white, and I came on down. And this is why I don't believe in toning my canvas. I think we talked about that in the last video. Now we have some liquid white that I picked up with a dirty brush. And we're just going to add that to the situation. And as you can see, I'm moving in upward strokes and kind of wave motion strokes. Splashing up against the rocks. Yes, there is another technique where I could paint every wave into the water. I'm not doing that.
In other words, this woman is just lazy and she makes me.
Because that is
work.
Not the main focus.
Ugh, I'm tired of carrying this painting.
Okay. Adding a little bit more of that phthalo blue. Here I'm adding a dirty black, which I mixed with some gambling. Galkit. As you can see, I'm not too particular about where it goes at this moment. I just know that I want some dark shading to give the effect of ripples and waves and bumps and crashes coming down this nice little stream. And then I am going to blend it in with a fan brush. I'm pretty sure there are other brushes that I could use, but for some reason, the fan brush seems like the king of all brushes. And here, we're going to start our piece de resistance. Full of it, ain't I? But I am going to be painting a tree, which is actually going to be the main focal point of the actual entire painting. Hence, my background is not too detailed. And right now, we're just going to add some limbs on. We're just going to start with the basic kid tree that you grew up painting and drawing and sketching. And there's no particular way that I'm actually putting it. I do know I want limbs to reach across the painting. I know I want some in the sky. That's all I know at that point.
In other words, this chick is just winging it. You are basically just here for me, King El Fazo. I just let her paint and play with her little canvas in between.
Does anyone want to adopt a cat? Apparently, he doesn't shut up. Oh, you can see that. And this is just a winky dink brush. I don't even know the name of this brush. I actually just pick brushes according to what type of effect I want to add. And here I'm switching to a liner brush to make a little bit more sharp branches that I want to float up into the sky and across the water. But I want them to be super thin. I don't even want you to know they're there. I know they're there.
But we just saw you paint them, so we know they're there too. I swear, just have patience with her, guys, please.
I am taking my tree across the water. Putting my tree in the sky, and at the end of this video, it's still going to be a barren tree. We still have one more video after this before we actually complete this painting. And when you paint your tree, it can be any shape you want it to be. You can take the time to paint every limb and stick and dip inside of the tree. But I choose to use a method that works for me. The limbs are very not important to me at all. They really aren't. They will add some depth and some texture later, but they are not the main focal point of my tree. And you will see what I mean later. So as you see, I'm dropping these in pretty quickly, pretty randomly, because in nature, things are random. Nothing is ever a straight line. And I don't want my tree to fit my painting. I want the tree to grow out of the painting. Here, I'm taking some of that same Indian yellow and liquid white, and I'm using it as a highlight. The paint is still very much so wet. At this point, I did not allow anything to dry. And yes, you can wait till things dry to add highlights and shadows and lights and things of that nature. But for the method that I like to use, this is actually the easiest way for me to add highlights that I like. Yes, I'm using the liner brush. Again, I use whatever brush I'm in the mood for. It's an old liner brush like that. It's worn down. I have a new one, but I don't have a need for it right now. Not for this painting. I'm being careful not to kill all my dark.
Killing all her dark. I'm busting
and
up in here.
I'm coming in with a fan brush. Again, there are blender brushes out there that could do this
she
job.
Is
but
cheap. Super cheap. She needs to buy me a new toy.
But you don't play with the toys you already have.
Don't let this girl fool you. She's just cheap. That is all.
Fuzzo, please give me a break. But I don't like those. I see no point for them when I can just have a light touch with a fan brush. So please check us out at Painting a Pathway on Facebook, Painting an Open Door on Instagram, here on YouTube, Painting an Open Door. And we will finish this up at a later video. Also, check out this guy. He is awesome and one of my favorite artists. Bye.